Hey there! In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up OBS so that it automatically pauses and unpauses your recording depending on whether or not the window you're working in is active. And it works pretty much with any software. No more manual switching, which can be annoying and sometimes you just simply forget, making your video way too large or even worse, it hasn't recorded your work at all. Setting everything up takes a few steps, but it isn't all that complicated. There are a couple of things you need to be aware of though, otherwise it might not work the way you want it to. Alright, here I have a completely new scene collection. I'm just gonna quickly add a display capture to this scene here and rename the scene Recording Scene. You can have pretty much anything in it, it doesn't really matter. Next up, right click on the scene and duplicate it. I'm gonna name it Pause Scene. You'll soon see why. Also, just to be safe, set the transitions to cut. We're not going to make any changes to this scene. It is supposed to be an exact copy of the recording scene. Okay, now go to Tools and then to Scripts. No worries, we don't have to do any scripting ourselves. Just click on the plus down here to add a script, which should open up this exact folder with a couple of scripts. No need to download anything either, you have these by default when you install OBS. If for some reason it doesn't open this folder, this is the path for finding it. Now the script we want is pause-scene.lua, only that one. Once you load it, you see this little description and the drop-down menu at the side. Select the pause scene in it. Alright, that's all we need to do here, so close the window. And go to Tools again, but this time click on the Automatic Scene Switcher. Here we got a bit more stuff going on. So firstly, set the When No Window Matches setting to Switch To and select the Pause Scene again. The amount of milliseconds for the active window check intervals doesn't matter all that much. The lowest value is 50 milliseconds, which is totally fine. I tested it and those checks don't put any noticeable extra strain on your CPU or anything. Now we need to tell this switcher what windows to look out for. I have Clip Studio Paint opened on the screen I'm recording, so I wanna choose that one. On the right, the recording scene should be selected, and then simply click the plus icon down here to add the window to the list. You can actually have several windows in here, which is also quite important and you'll soon see why. Alright, now you only need to set the scene switcher to active down here and close the window. Let's do a test recording. It starts the recording even when OBS is selected, so it doesn't start in the paused state unfortunately. But let me click into Clip Studio. Still recording, very good. Now I'm clicking another window, like back to OBS for example. And you see that it automatically paused. The scene has also switched to the pause scene over here. And because of that, the script that we added pauses the recording. And when I click back into Clip Studio, it switches back to the recording scene. Therefore, it will resume the recording because we are not in the pause scene anymore. When we take a look at this test recording, we can see that the animation got interrupted, showing that the pausing works. Okay, so you may ask why the pause scene has to be a copy of the recording scene. Well, let me show you what happens if I turn the display capture off here in the pause scene so that we only have a black screen. Gonna time-lapse for the recording process again. So now we see these black flickers in the test recordings. That's because the pausing doesn't happen instantaneously. Remember the active window check intervals that we chose in milliseconds? There is a small time gap between us switching the window and the next check OBS does to see if anything got switched. During that small time interval, one or several frames of the pause screen are getting recorded too. If it's the exact same scene, then you won't notice anything, like in the first test recording I showed you. Because those few video frames from the pause scene are the exact same thing happening after all. But if the pause scene is different, then you'll notice. And you'll probably want to edit those flickers out later, which is just annoying extra work. Alright, you might think now that everything is perfectly set up and ready to go. Well, there is a small issue. It doesn't take pop-up windows into account. Stuff like menus open up from the same software you want to record. When I try to edit the colors, for example, I get this little window and the recording has been paused. And it resumes again when I close it. In case you do want those little extra windows recorded too, you need to go back to the automatic scene switcher in the tools again and add this window to the list. You can only do that while the window is opened. Also, make sure you open the window before you open the scene switcher settings, otherwise it won't show up in the drop-down list. No worries, it won't disappear from the list when you close it. There we go, still recording even while the little window is opened. And there can be many of those kinds of windows, making the list real long, real fast. Now you can manually unpause the recording after OBS automatically paused it, and it will resume the recording when you get back to the windows in the switcher list, but that's annoying extra work, which you also might simply forget about. And isn't that exactly what we wanted to prevent? So yeah, this is not a perfect solution. But if you exactly know what windows you need, or maybe you need only one, then this feature can be really convenient. Like for example, when you want to record a long project for a drawing time-lapse video. By the way, if you want to also learn how to set up the recording settings for some time-lapse footage, you can watch my other tutorial video about exactly that, together with an explanation of how Clip Studio Paint's time-lapse feature works, in case you also use the software. And if you want to learn how to take that real-time footage and make an actual time-lapse out of it, then I have a video for it too, using some free and easy-to-use video editing software. Okay, that's it for this video. As always, if you have any questions or constructive feedback, then please leave a comment down below. Keep in mind though that I am not their tech support. Alright then, thank you a lot for watching, and see you next time.